Basic geometrical ideas. Hello children. In today's class, we will learn about the basic of geometry. Before that, let's recap some important points. A solid has a surface which may be flat or curved. Flat surfaces are known as plane surfaces, which extend indefinitely in all directions. For example, top of the table, surface of a sheet of paper, etc. A point is a mark of position. Point has no length, breadth, or thickness. The straight path between two points is called line segment. This is denoted by AB. A and B are end points. A line segment extended endlessly on both sides is called a line. A line segment extended endlessly in one direction is called a ray. Two rays having a common end point form an angle. The symbol stands for angle. Point. A point is a mark of position. It has no dimension, that is, it has no length, breadth, and height. Point is denoted by a small dot. Line, line segment, and ray. A line can extend indefinitely in both directions. It has no endpoints. A line has only length. It does not have any breadth or thickness. A line does not have a definite length. A line can also be represented by small alphabets like L, M, N, P, etc. Intersecting lines. If two lines have one common point, they are called intersecting lines. Parallel lines. Two lines in a plane that do not intersect or meet each other at any point are called parallel lines. Here, AB is parallel to CD. Line segment. Let A and B be two points on a plain paper. The straight path from A to B is called the line segment, AB. This is denoted by AB. The points A and B are called the end points of line. The distance between the points A and B is called the length of AB. The edges of a table, edges of ruler, etc. are the examples of line segments. Ray. A line segment extended endlessly in one direction is called a ray. A line segment AB extended in the direction from A to B and marked by an arrow at B represents a ray AB, denoted by AB. For example, light emerging from a torch or the light rays from the sun. A ray is a part of a line with one end point. Let's find the points and line segments in the given figure. We can see that there are 6 points. They are points A, B, F, C, D, and E. The line segments are AB, BC, CD, DA, AE, ED, BF, and CF. Let's proceed further to learn about curves. A line or outline which gradually deviates from being straight for some or all of its length is known as curves. A curve that does not cross itself is called a simple curve. Look at these figures. These are few examples of curves. Open and closed curves. The curves which do not begin and end at the same point are called open curves. Closed curves. The curves which begin and end at the same point are called closed curves. And the closed curves which do not cross themselves are called simple closed curves. The two figures are examples of closed curves. Curvy linear boundaries. A line which marks the limits of an area is known as boundary, whereas a closed figure bounded by curved lines is said to have curvy linear boundaries. For example, two points on a globe. Linear boundaries. A closed figure bounded by straight lines is said to have linear boundaries. For example, sheet of paper. Polygons. A closed figure made by joining three or more line segments is known as polygons. In polygons, each line segment intersect exactly two other line segments. For example, triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, and hexagon. Angles. An angle is made up of rays that have the same end point. The end points at which two rays meet is called the vertex of the angle, and the rays forming the angle are called its arms or sides. It is represented by the symbol. Naming of angles. Let's see the given figure. In this, we can see that angle has two arms AB and AC with vertex A. We can name this angle as angle BAC or angle CAB. It can also be called as angle A. We label any other angle with a small letter or a number placed between the arms of the angle and near the vertex. Interior of an angle. The space between the arms of an angle is called the interior of the angle. The given figure, we can see that points P, Q, and R are set to line in the interior of the angle. Exterior of an angle. The space outside the arms of an angle is called the exterior of the angle. The points U, V, and T are the exterior points of angle. Adjacent angles. Two angles with one common arm and a common vertex that lie on either side of the common arm are called adjacent angles. The shown figure is an example of adjacent angle. Triangle. Simple closed figure which is made up of three line segments is called a triangle. The symbol of triangle is. In the given figure, triangle PQR is denoted as triangle PQR. It can also be termed in different ways, such as triangle QRP, triangle RPQ, triangle RQP, or triangle PRQ. Vertices. The point of intersection of two adjacent sides of a triangle is known as vertex of triangle. In any triangle like triangle ABC, A, B, and C are vertices of triangle ABC. Quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is a closed figure made up of four straight edges and four corners. It is also named as quadrangle. The given figure is the example of quadrilateral with four sides AB, BC, CD, and DA. It is also defined as a closed figure which is formed by four line segments. It has four sides and four angles. Its four angles are angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. Parts of quadrilateral. Sides and angles. In quadrilateral ABCD, the four line segments AB, BC, CD, and DA are called its sides, and the four angles angle DAB, angle ABC, angle BCD, and angle CDA are known as its angles. Adjacent sides. Two sides are said to be adjacent if they have a point in common or common end point. Adjacent angles. Two angles are said to be adjacent angles if they have a common arm. In quadrilateral ABCD, angle A and angle B are adjacent angles as they have a common arm AB. Opposite sides. Two sides are said to be opposite sides if they are not adjacent sides. Opposite angles. Two angles are said to be opposite angles if they have no common arm or if they are not adjacent angles. Angle A and angle C, angle B and angle D are the pairs of opposite sides. Diagonals. The line segments which join the opposite vertices or the two non-consecutive vertices is called a diagonal. Convex quadrilateral. If a line segment joining any two vertices of a quadrilateral lies within the quadrilateral only, it is known as convex quadrilateral. Concave quadrilateral. If at least one line segment joining any two vertices is not lying wholly into it, then the quadrilateral is known as concave quadrilateral. Circle. A circle is a simple closed curve of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point on a given plane or surface. Center. The fixed point in the plane which is at equal distance from every point on the surface or boundary of a circle is known as center of the circle. Radius. The line segment joining the center of the circle to any point of a circle is known as radius. Diameter. The line segment which passes through the center of a circle and whose endpoints lie on the surface of the circle is known as diameter of the circle. Circumference. The length of the boundary of a circle is its circumference. Look at the figure. Chord. The line segment formed by joining any two points on the circle is called its chord. Arc. An arc is a part of the circle between any two points. In the given figure, PQR and PIR are the arc of the circle. Arcs PQR and PIR can be symbolically written as the region in the interior of the circle enclosed by an arc and the corresponding chord is known as a segment. The larger part that contains the center of the circle is called the major segment. And the smaller part that does not contain the center of the circle is called the minor segment of the circle. Semicircle. The diameter of a circle divides the circle into two equal parts. Each divided part is known as semicircle.